In this part, we will investigate the areas of stars like this one, curvilinear triangle of squares like this one, with the help of regular polygons and their associated parabolas. The polygons will be in this part only equilateral triangle and squares, like this. Like this for the square. Here we start from a square. The four parabolas, you see curvilinear square. You can see a first star, which is this one. And if we zoom out, a biggest one. And for the triangle, as it was described at the beginning of the presentation, we start from an equilateral triangle, three parabolas, and we can get here a curvilinear triangle and a star with three petals. So let us start with this case, and you see that we need to evaluate the area of this curvilinear triangle, so we need to evaluate the area of this curvilinear one, and to evaluate it we will construct some points on these two parabolas and construct, thanks to these points, a polygon which area is displayed here. And if we want to get an approximation of the curvilinear triangle, we have to add the area of the gray triangle and three times the area of the yellow polygon. And if you want to visualize better using rotations, you can see that we can evaluate the ratio between the curvilinear triangle and the gray initial triangle, which is 226, not very far from 225. Is it 225? You will see that no, for very easy reasons to find. And now, what about this star? The technique will be a bit the same. You see that I've constructed a polygon with some points of these two parabolas and evaluated the area of this blue petal. Three times plus this area gave this the area of the star. And here you have the ratio. A better visualization here, and the ratio is 22.78. If we evaluate the ratio of this ratio, which is the ratio between the area of the blue star and the initial triangle, we get 10, nearly 10. Is it 10? I don't know. It's an open problem. Now, with a square and four parabolas, here we have three surfaces to evaluate, three areas, and you see that I've improved the technique to have a better representation and a more stable construction, because if I change the position of this point, my figure is always similar to the original figure. And what did we do? We have constructed by rotation all these points, created this regular yellow polygon, and evaluated the ratio between the gray and the yellow one, 149. Is it 150? We'll see that no. Same technique for this petal. And we obtain a ratio, which is this one between the area of the blue star and the initial triangle. And for the biggest star, same technique, a long work, but easy to do. And you see the result is this one. So we cannot, collect all this data and try to find some pattern. I didn't find them. And other ratio. So what about the proof? How to evaluate the area of this curvilinear square? To subtract to the area of the square, four times the area of this part of the plane limited by the x-axis, the red and the blue curves. We know the equation of these curves, and you see that we have the equation of these two parabolas as presented in the reminder, substituting one equation in the other, and we can get the least of the zeros of this one, and the zero we want is especially the second one, because you can see under the figure the second point of intersection between these two parabolas is on the left side, and here we can do that to see what I told you. Can see that it's not what we want. So what about what we have to do? We have the ordinate of the intersection point. To get the abscissa, let us put in this equation, and we have two integrals to evaluate here, and the area of the curvilinear triangle is given by this formula. For a equal 1, this result, and the inverse of this number only with this 6 digit is that there is difference between these two numbers, because if I choose to change the settings, and in the document settings I choose exact, you will see that we obtain the result, which is here. Very complicated, and the last one is more simple. That completes this part, and in the next part we'll focus our attention on the initial problem with the equilateral triangle.